energy going to Citi Field for me all the time is always like a good thing. It's always, yeah, so for sure, I definitely didn't expect it was going to be a no-hitter. The starting pitcher, I remember, was Tylor Megill. The closer, of course, was Edwin Diaz. I know Drew Smith was in there. Every time I go to Citi Field, the energy is always good. It's always high. I love the Mets. They're my favorite team. I have a lot of passion for them. So the energy was, it was definitely high. It was good. And I go by myself a lot. At night, I went by myself again. But, you know, being there, the energy's there. You know, the energy's there for sure. So being surrounded by a bunch of Mets fans, it's always a good time.
So when I was taking this training go to school, I saw a guy who was running from the platform he was on. He ran to jump over to the next platform because I'm assuming he got on the wrong side for his train. So when I was going through middle school, high school, even elementary school, I would always take the train / bus. It was a hassle, but you know, I got my own car now, so it helps. But back then, definitely, yeah.
It was definitely when I was on the subway one time. We was in the city traveling around. Some kids started fighting.
How did the fight start, if you recall?
We don't know, honestly. We just heard a bunch of yelling, and somebody was like, oh, they're pushing each other. And then we didn't know if they were joking or not. We just seen the whole thing. We were going to go like to get some barbecue, hang out in the city pretty much. That was about it.
Oh, dude. Oh, my God. Well, see, I have plenty of stories, but the one story that always sticks with me was me and my friends were on a subway train at like 8:30 at night, and we're trying to go back home. So we get on the train, and there's just this big, like, juice head, muscled up. I'm talking, like, tank top. Like, I saw my reflection in his bicep. I was like, holy shit. So he's, like, he's just sitting down, and my friend gets on the train with us, and he bumps onto his leg. And he's like, oh, shit, man, I'm sorry. The dude gets up and almost hits the top of, like the top of the train. Like, he's 7 foot tall. Crazy. Crazy specimen. So he looks at my friend and he goes, yo, we got a problem? And he starts walking towards my friend and he just grabs him. And meanwhile, the train doors are still open, right? So he just grabs him and just throws him out the train. And as soon as he throws him out the train, the door's shut. So we're stuck on the subway train and we have to go, we have to take one back to go pick him up. But the whole subway ride to the other train, I didn't look at him. We didn't look at the guy or anything. We are terrible friends, but listen, I wasn't trying to get thrown out of the train. You got to understand that.
Yeah.
This was, I think, 2 years ago. This was my junior year of high school. Yeah, this was like the end of my junior year. We wanted to go take a trip down to New York just to celebrate, and that happened.
I was in the Bronx, somewhere in the Bronx, and I was with a friend, and then he was texting me. He was like, oh, this fucking dude owes me fucking like $2,000. Spin the block. And then I spin the block, and then I see that, you know, he has three other friends, like out of nowhere. So, mind you, I'm in a Toyota Corolla, really small. I pick up three huge dudes, and so now I got 3 6-foot dudes in my back, this guy on my right, and then so we go to another place, and we go out of the car, and we confront him. He's like, hey, you owe me a couple grand. He's like, no, I fucking don't. Boom, punch. It's like 5 against 5. It's an all-out brawl. I'm like coming down from like, I'm like smoking, I'm like kind of like out of it, but then like my, you know, I'm in there, I'm having a brawl, boom, 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 round one. Everybody leaves, they go back, spin the block again. But now another set of cars, so now it goes from a 5v5 to a 10v10. On the street, somebody has a knife, boom, someone gets that. And they're like, you know, we're like taunting each other, ah, bah, fuck you. So I have to take this guy to the hospital, you know, pick him up, drop him off. The next day, everybody that was in the fight went back to that guy's house. Everyone's like dressed almost like all white, and I felt like it was Sunday also, so it was like recovering, and then everybody was, it was like almost like Sunday barbecue feeling where it's like, hey, we, you know, we got out of it, you know, he has like a little like bandage like, womp, womp, like right here, and then he, you know, he dabs me up, he's like, yo, I appreciate you a lot, bro, I appreciate you fighting with me, man, you know, we gotta be together, you know, you're my brother. I haven't talked to him since then, but that day, you know, after that, I went to church with my family. I prayed to God, and that was a pretty cool experience.
I went to the Global Citizen Festival, which is like a big music festival for charity in the city, in Central Park, and it was like so packed full of people. There was huge names there. Janet Jackson was like headlining that. The Weeknd was there, and I wasn't close to the stage, but I was not far in reference. There was like, you turn around, there's like a sea of people. There's so many bodies there. And so towards the end of the night, There was like a bang from like close to the stage, like the gates, something happened. There was a big bang. And at the time, you know, New York City, everyone thinks there's like a shooting happening. Basically, you hear a loud noise and it's, you know, everyone's scared, rightfully so. So I heard a loud bang. I looked at my friends, we're like, what was that? We turn around, like, it was empty. Like, everyone had just started running out. So then, you know, everyone's running, I'm gonna run. So we started, like, Usain Bolt's hurtling over gates, running. And, like, as you're running, you see, like, picnic blankets with, like, Jordans. Just, like, people left everything there. People left everything there. And yeah, we ran out, we ran to a Starbucks, we called an Uber. Turns out it wasn't a shooter, like a gate fell or something. But everyone had cleared the fucking whole park and they were like, it's safe, you can come back. No, we did not go back. Traumatized, I went home.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond